Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's check the price of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And we see that most of the major cryptocurrencies, they have recorded a decent price decline for the last 24 hours. For example, Bitcoin dropped by 3.8%, Ethereum by 9.2%, and so on. In this way, I think that we can say that the market is just consolidating or is moving sideways. Of course, it's quite volatile, but in general, the market is moving sideways. Today, that's why I want to comment on the decentralized finance subsector or sector of the cryptocurrency world. For example, some of the tokens from the decentralized finance world have been doing relatively well. For example, that's Chainlink, that has entered the top 10 cryptocurrencies by market cap. Also, for example, if we scroll down, UMA is doing quite well. Yearn Finance, for example, the chart, the price chart of this cryptocurrency is really, really crazy. Let me show it to you. It used to be less than $1,000 2 months ago. And I remember that many people on Hive blockchain used to comment on it. For example, this is the chart. You can check that. In the first half of July, it was something like $1,000 and it was $38 or $39 just a couple of days ago. So for 2 months, it has increased by 30 times, 34. So this is really something crazy. Now it's 30,000. And what I want to say is, yes, there is some kind of hype in the decentralized finance world. Their tokens have increased significantly. The media outlets comment nowadays actively on this topic, on decentralized finance. For example, you can find many articles about it. This is the first one. Then you can, this is Cointelegraph, for example. They just commented on some cryptocurrency hot dog. And there are many, many articles. For example, if you check, for example, CoinDesk as well, they wrote an article recently about Yearn Finance. You can find articles about Uniswap exchange that has been doing relatively well. For example, the article's name is DeFi Flippening Comes to Exchanges as Uniswap Topples Coinbase and TradingView. For example, Uniswap, this exchange, decentralized exchange, has been doing relatively well. They published a tweet recently that Uniswap outperformed Coinbase on a daily basis by trading volume. So we see that decentralized exchanges, they are doing really very well. There is huge demand for such kind of services. So this is really a big hype. You can even check, they have a section. They have a section on the site of CoinGecko DeFi. So here are the major tokens, Chainlink, UMA, Yearn Finance, and so on. And you can check their price charts and you will see that they have skyrocketed. Of course, now their prices are a little bit declining, so it's the market experiencing some kind of pullback. And of course, now people try to figure out if this was a bubble or if it is a bubble that is going to burst the decentralized finance world. I want to say that recently I talked with some cryptocurrency enthusiasts in person here when we go to coffee shops and talk about the global economy, the cryptocurrency world. Some people claim that this decentralized finance world is a massive bubble that is about to burst and people will, or investors will suffer a lot because their tokens will hit the ground, they will go to zero. I don't agree with this, and I will share my point of view today why I don't agree with this. So once again, now when some of the cryptos are experiencing this decline, for example, you can find that some people are trying to say that this sector is really a bubble. For example, DeFi Memecoin hot dog dumps 99% in hours after lunch. So that was an unsuccessful lunch. And some people now, they start to claim that this is the end of the DeFi bubble and it's going to burst. So this is the chart of the capitalization of the decentralized finance sector, according to DeFi Pulse, 9.34 billions. And fellas, if it is a bubble, it means that this is a very big, market capitalization. The market is overbought or overpriced and it's going to burst. I don't agree with this. Let me explain you my point of view why I don't think it is a bubble. First of all, let's check the market capitalization of one of the regional banks in Europe, UniCredit. Its market cap is 18 billion. So this bank is a part of the centralized finance world. It is just a regional bank in Europe. It's not a big bank all over the world. Of course, it has some, branches in other countries outside Europe, but it's still a regional player in my view, and it has a market cap of 18 billion. If we check another major bank in Europe, Crédit Agricole, for example, it has a market cap of 24 billion. If compared with the decentralized finance world, we see that all those famous projects, they have a market cap less than one regional bank in Europe. Do you think it is a bubble? This centralized world that is really probably its market cap is massive, and just one bank representative of the centralized finance world has a market cap much more than this market cap. Let's check some US banks. For example, Wells Fargo, $100 billion. JP Morgan, $309 billion. So this is massive market capitalization. Imagine if we take the Chinese leading banks. The market capitalization just of the banks that are part of the centralized finance world will surpass $2 or $3 trillion in my view. So it is really about trillions of dollars. And if we compare it with this decentralized finance world, this is just a piece in the ocean. This is just a small drop in the ocean. So this is a tiny, a very small market cap. That's why I don't think that this is a bubble. Of course, probably this solid or rapid growth is to some extent unsustainable, and we will witness some kind of pullback. Even Vitalik Buterin, I remember in a recent podcast in the second half of August, talk about the DeFi, and he said yes, the market is a little bit probably overbought, there is a hype, and the growth is unsustainable, but it has a bright future, big perspectives. It's just a matter of time when it will hit 10 billions, 20 billions, 50 billions, 100 billions. It may take years, but it will start to compete with the world of the centralized world and with the centralized banks. So this market is going to grow. Probably some projects will turn out to be unsuccessful, but new projects will come. And definitely it is just the beginning of this, money. Yes, in the near future, we can see some pullbacks, significant pullbacks, be very careful, but I'm pretty sure that in 1 year from now, or in 2 years from now, or in 3 years from now, we will have many more billions of dollars locked or as a market capitalization, of the decentralized world. It's just a matter of time. And that's why I just want to show you the last thing. For example, if we check the exchanges, of course, we all know these solid exchanges such as Binance, Coinbase, Kraken, and etc. If we check their volumes, normalized volumes, for example, Binance is the leading cryptocurrency for the last 24 hours. Okay, exchange. But the third one is Uniswap. That is a decentralized exchange. And it has already on a daily basis almost $1 billion as a trading volume. So this is a massive progress. I remember last year, it was even unimaginable. We cannot, I'm pretty sure that people last year didn't expect that such things will happen in 1 year time. So this is a massive progress. This is a massive progress for the DeFi sector. And I'm pretty sure that even if we have some kind of pullbacks, price declines in the near future, in the long run, this sector will prosper. It's just a matter of time. That's it for today, fellas. Please share your point of view as a comment under this video. I wish you a wonderful day and hope to see you in the next one. It was me at CryptoSpy.